nimefanya kazi na yeye bunge ana coordinator. Let me say a prayer to the family, the bishop, and the bishop again for losing millions. The truth is, there's nobody and your daughter at the same time. The nation, unless you're going through yourself. And if you didn't love your wife, go and love her even more. And the stories about losing your wife and child and the circumstances are even more troubling. Our presence here is enough. When we were last here to discuss this matter, alituambia kwamba he could not speak for a week. Hakuzungumza for one full week, even to his own parents. So please don't underestimate what James is going through. It's a difficult task. And unfortunately, Moses, I can tell you, his supermarket was raided nearly at the same time as when he lost his wife. And I want to speak to that because it's unfortunate. Now, a supermarket is raided during maandamano. Vitu zani. Yani ya kukata roo. Akatoa stock from one shop to the other. Na wale watu ambao wapende wa mali, wakasema watakuja kuchoma ile kwa wote. Hiyo tukazuia. Let me say why peace is important. And I want to explain because it is in this region. Hapa kwa barabara, there is an investment of 400 million shillings. It is called the Superstore. Ambaye nilikuwa nifungue last Tuesday. It is the first superstore in Kenya on a highway. Ambaye iko na msikiti, iko na kanisa, iko na kila kitu. 400 million shillings. Moja nature chief kiamba, chairman the wing major is 21 million shillings. What about it? Upper Sultan is distributing that water to 15 water points in Sultan. Pale juu, mali mwambao kulikufa watu, tisa, mwachine, there's yet more there, 30 cubic meters. It's being distributed to 14 water points. What am I saying? We are lucky that we have people who care for us. And if we show that we don't care for our own things, why do you think they will care for us? Eh? What are the moka? Maka kede mo baby, eh? Ema koka? So nataka niwashukuru watu wa hapa, area ya Kilomena. Tunazika kijana wa grade 4 in a place called Kadhulumbe. And a bullet, stray bullet from a high caliber rifle came through the bus into his head. Yes. A stray bullet. Now what do we tell people like that? What do we say as a country? So, in as much as maybe I welcome peace and a grand coalition government, I am just left with questions. Did young children have to die for ODM to get seats in government? These people have to be drowned so that we get people in government. I don't understand. Are politicians deaf, including myself, to the status of this country? I think when we speak about this country, let's be serious. Na wale wasikie kwa sababu. We could have silenced the young people with guns. But they will never forget that when they spoke to their parents, we turned to bullets to silence them. There is a place I really cherish called Parliament. And we believed Parliament was hallowed grounds. I was very saddened that one child died outside the parliamentary gates. And the people resuscitated to Kichwa. What was there to steal in Parliament? Na hapo hiyo ni mali ya wananchi. So we must tell this government, and I must say so, because if I don't say so, I will not sleep at night. You have let down the young people of this country. You know what I mean? Because when you sleep at night, what do you tell them? Because the people you have picked to join government are not young people. Ni wazee. Ni wakongwe pia wengine. It's bad. So as James Maluga, as we plead for you to join government, mukifungua zile iPad pale, and I pray for you to become a minister. Mukifungua hiyo iPad, may it flash the lives of those young people. Hizo ma iPad mnafungua kwa pavilion state house. May the mnakumbuka Rex. So that any decision you make going forward, you must remember that we did need to lose 50 young people for you to sit down. Why? Because our forefathers lost blood for us to get independence. What was our Nikufa Wengi? But let me ask you, good people, a question. 2007, watu wakufe tufanye grand coalition. 2013 or 2019, watu wangine wakufe tufanye handshake. Ingine munaita broad-based. How many people must lose lives for us to get stents into our heads? Moses Kodian. It's not fair. Kenyans have been taken for granted. And I hope we can find solutions. Because wale watu, mimi nikiwa bunge, wale watu walipitisha madeni ni serikali ilikuwa inaitwa handshake. Sindilikuwa hapo. And I opposed the motion with 7 other gallant senators about increasing debt of this country. Now since grant hiyo nini handshake ndio ilifanya hiyo kitu, sasa tutafute solution. You will sweat. Yes, the debt thing. But Moses Kuria and other people, including his classmates, have good ideas as to how we can deal with debt. So Moses Kuria, don't give up. Because the debt you have incurred in the government you served, both previous and present, is going to be paid by your great-grandchildren that are still in your loins. If we don't find a solution. Either that or we auction a part of this country to the Chinese. So it's important. Don't give up the solutions of how we can deal with debt. Because the problems of these young people is that you have transferred to debt to them, yet they have nothing.
Yes.
And unazaliwa wewe, you are minus 30,000 shillings on the day you are born. It's a sad story. Na pesa ingine hiyo debt ingia kwa mfuko ya wanaume. So James, we call upon you and send you. This gentleman envisioned a coalition before. Now I'm gonna be same way. And the next person who picked that phone call was the Deputy President Rigathi. I said, "We can't go to Chunga. We need to engage with the Kenya." Now I shall measure India. I said, "Kiu wana tu kumbele." The most important thing for us is a peaceful country. Nani mwaya leze mwani. We have got many friends who want to help us. Nataka mfikiri. Leo tumekuwa na kongamano ya magavana. Kwa sababu serikali imesema bilioni 20 lazima ziondolewe katika mpangilio wa pesa ambazo zitaenda kwa counties. Makweli is going to lose 400 and something million shillings. Na hizo si mshahara. Hizo ni pesa za maendeleo. I'm still asking for the government to reconsider the position of deducting counties' money. The people who are going to raise mabango even bigger than the ones for Gen Z's, yeah, what will kill me? Now what will kill me? Because where will, what will we do? It will be vitu zingine zifungwe. With less than 400 million in a budget of development, kila kitu inaweza kusimama. So let's pray for this country. Let's have peace. Because it is that peace that will guarantee the people that we represent can get something more, can get medicine in hospitals, can get an ambulance that is functional, can get water, can get food, etc., etc. Mimi naombea amani. I'm a peaceful man, and I pray that we have peace. Because even with a big car and without peace and food in your table, on your table or in your house, ukinunua chakula na hakuna, wale wa Somali wanajua. You can keep whatever you want in your house, but if your neighbor is not in peace, your house are not in peace. Thank you, Bishop Chule, for taking us back to school on light. You've just reminded me of a pinhole camera. And your eye is like a pinhole camera that inverts the image. I wanted to be a priest, but I became a lawyer. And if I was a priest, I would have explained to my good friend James Baruka what this is about. As a lawyer, I was trying to ask the questions, why? And I'm still left with the questions, why? You've been left by a young lady who you loved and a child. Question why? May her soul rest in peace together with your daughter, Satanza.
Asante, ongezeni gavana makofi.